Democratic Party.
Thank you. Mr. Speaker, for a number of years, our party, along with labor groups and other activists, have called on the government to implement a $15 minimum wage on the road to a living wage. Now, the Premier, when asked about this a little while ago, said about a $15 minimum wage that he, and I'll table this, that he, quote, would worry about the impact that would have on our economy with less people working, unquote. But a couple of weeks ago, economist David Carr was awarded the Nobel Prize in Economics for his research showing that increases in the minimum wage do not result in unemployment or in reduced employment. So I want to ask the Premier, is he prepared to revisit or to reconsider his previous opposition to a $15 minimum wage?
The Honourable Premier.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And what I would say to the member on this important topic is we are focused on making sure that Nova Scotia is a province where everyone can see opportunities for themselves and reach their full potential right here in this province. $15 is a number for some people. Some people strive much higher than that. But what I would say to the member is that we're focused on making sure that there are jobs in this economy, in this province, that pay a satisfactory amount, a suitable amount, an appropriate amount, so that everyone that wakes up and goes to work every single day earns enough to afford groceries, shelter, and the quality of life that they have a right to respect right here in this province. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable Leader of the New Democratic Party.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I think these are entirely appropriate words for the Premier to use. A satisfactory wage, a suitable wage, an appropriate wage. So we know that we have a third of the people working for wages in Nova Scotia are making less than $15 an hour today, and that they're working for large businesses, a majority of them. Now, in an interview not long ago, the Premier added to these words, suitable and appropriate, I think another proper word to describe this. He said, although he didn't support a $15 minimum wage, he did think it was important for people to have a fair wage. So what I want to ask the Premier is, does he think that $12.95 is a suitable, appropriate, a fair wage for a person working in Nova Scotia?
The Honourable Premier.
I would thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I thank the member. And what I would say is that we want Nova Scotians to believe that the economy is growing, that they can participate in the economy, that they can make a living in this province, they can thrive in this province. That's what I would say. And my concerns remain around the member's position that it would cause fewer people working on certain shifts. It could lead to job loss. We will have a philosophical disagreement on that, and that's okay. We just have to accept that we have a disagreement on that. But we know our economy has came through a pretty difficult time as well. Right now, we're focused on rebuilding the economy, moving forward, and making sure that Nova Scotians can earn a fair wage, earn a suitable wage, earn a satisfactory wage, but above all of that, can enjoy a quality of life in this province where they can reach their full potential.
The Honourable Leader of the New Democratic Party on his final supplementary.
Thank you. So this whole idea of have a quality of life, this speaks to the idea of a living wage, which we know is actually quite a bit more than $15 an hour. A living wage being defined as what two earners in a household have to make in order for there to cover the cost of living and have basic, decent living conditions in that family's home. Now, in Halifax, that's been defined as $20.70 an hour. And there are a number of jurisdictions in North America now, as well as a number of companies, that are declaring living wage policies, not just for their employees, but also for their suppliers. Cyclesmith in Halifax is one of them. So I want to ask the Premier, is he prepared to lead Nova Scotia to a position where we will be able to declare the province of Nova Scotia as a living wage jurisdiction?
The Honourable Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And what I would say to the member is I'm prepared to lead this province to the place where people all over the world see Nova Scotia as the province of opportunity. And that is what I see for this province, and that is what more and more people are seeing. So it is my hope that every person who wants to live and work in Nova Scotia can find that opportunity right here and reach their full potential. That is my hope, and that's where I lead the province. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.